So we are living in a world of internet where internet is everything, and to access the internet we have desktop, tablet and mobile, and our world is now inside our mobile. This world, that means the internet, works on a simple protocol which is called hypertext transfer protocol, or simply HTTP. And think about protocol just as the rules, because rules are rules. But in the beginning of the internet was designed to share information between one computer to another computer placed apart. But because we are living in 2017, and this means we need machine to machine talking. And what is that? Suppose you have one machine and another machine. Both machines work on a different kind of operating system, different language, different situations, and they have to share the data between these two, and all these processes happen without the involvement of the humans. But you know, the actual soul of any machine is its software. So actually we need softwares to talk. That's cool. But why we need the machine to machine talking? Let me explain you. Actually, IoT is the future, and what IoT stands for, IoT means the Internet of Things. In the future, you have a house or you have a car, and you can access the house, or you can open and close the door, start, stop, geyser or AC, something like that. And also the car, you can send the information about how much fuel is that, how much speed is that. And not only that, even a simple toaster can be included in Internet of Things, can be accessed by using internet. That's cool. But we have the browsers to talk to machine. Yeah, this means we, the humans, can talk to machine by using the browser, and not this kind of human. And whenever you request any page via browser, you will get the data along with that HTML and CSS, because HTML CSS is intended to design to have the page looks more readable for human, but machine needs machine readable data. So what we have to do, we have to think about that. Yeah, here comes our APIs. And what API is? API is application programming interface. And you know, interface means connecting any two, and that's exactly what we want. But what an API can do for us? API allow two software program to communicate with each other, and that's exactly our sole purpose. Okay, API can be local and web and program API. But in this episode, we are only talking about the web API. But what web API can do for us? So suppose you have a website or you have a mobile app, and in mobile app you want to get the weather information and the GMAP for your user, but your device cannot have a sensor to sense the weather information, and even it has, it can sense only the information where the mobile is placed, not the information of whole world. But there are some websites which can give you the data or the weather information of any city in the world. So here is the interesting point. So let's see some example. Let's go to Chrome and open weathermap.org. This website gives you the information of weather of every big city in this world. So let's talk about Mumbai. So search for Mumbai and you will get the Mumbai here, and here is the information. Let's search about London and you will search for London. London is here, London, US, sky is clear, everything is good. But how will I get this information on my mobile app? So for that, here comes our APIs. So you can see here is the API tab, and let's get this API current weather data, and let's search for London. So new tab, and you will get the data like this. So actually the same data we have received here is now in a structured way here. So this is actually the machine readable data, and this is the human readable data, and I think you got the point. To think about API as a waiter who can take the order from you, go to kitchen and come back with the order you have placed. Similarly, web API can get the request from a machine, go back to server and get back the data to the requested machine. But what we have to do to create an API? Actually, we know that there are many developers in the world having knowledge of various kinds of languages. So we need a concept or a structured way of creating an API so that everyone in this world, that means every developer, can follow that way. Here comes our hero called REST. And okay, I'm not talking about this kind of REST, so dear, you have to go, so bye bye. Okay, so REST stands for representational state transfer, and what it's mean by that, it's not a web service, it's a concept design or architecture. What the architecture mean? Architecture, if you heard this word, you will come up like this picture. But the actual word meaning of the architecture is the art or practice of designing and constructing buildings. I'm not talking about the buildings, but same is true with the REST also. We are going to build our data in a structure or a proper way. Okay, so suppose you have lots of data, you have to structure it. Think about this as the database having many kind of tables, having many relationships, and if a machine requests data from your server, then you will give the data in a JSON format. JSON stands for JavaScript Object Notation. And how it's look like? It's look like this. So the machine will get the data in this format as we have seen on the weather API .org, and you can see the curly braces, then query pages, and all the information in this pages object. So every API has to follow this way. That means the REST way of creating the API. Okay, so some of the REST basics are, whenever you are creating an API in a RESTful way, that means if you want to read the data, you have to send a GET request. Similarly to write, you have to send the POST request and put for edit and delete. For delete, you know, that's good. But all these information are transferred on single thing, which is called HTTP, as I have told you. And you know, same thing is true for internet. That means our websites, our browsers, our APIs, everything works on a same platform called URL, route, or resource, or HTTP, or anything you can call it. You don't have to create a new platform for the APIs. The same platform used by humans is used by the machines. So we have seen that REST is not a web service, but let's see what is web service. It's a collection of open protocol and standard used for exchanging data, and this is actually we want. That means a machine running on any kind of operating system, having any kind of languages, we have to transfer the data between two machines. This means an API created in a REST way is a web service, because web service is designed to exchange the data between any two kind of machines. And this is the conclusion of this episode, which says that to have communication between machines, we need API. Web API are machine readable form of your web page. So some websites are also consuming their own API, and they need a standard which we call REST. So if you like this episode, please give it a thumbs up, share with the others so that everyone know what is RESTful API. Don't forget to subscribe, like Bitfumes on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Bye bye.